stuff. That's
slippery. Pretty slippery. Want to make sure whatever you're doing doesn't
combat with you guys.
Yeah, can't.
That would be too vision drained.
I'll do a cloth and get that all off of there. You do it. So you want to, there's not much on this side.
It's perfect on that side. That's exactly what we want.
Braided rope?
Yeah, it's kind of, that's exactly what it is, actually, a wax rope.
Mm. Just go straight down on it. Fill my threads up with shit, Lonnie. Geez.
Careful, it's gonna be.
It's soft stuff, so it's all good. Like we're putting metal fragments into
this
it.
This has got asbestos in it. Did you sign the waiver with the Carnian chicken guy?
I drink asbestos.
Oh, okay. Well, you're one of those authentic guys.
Yeah. I do brakes and all that kind of stuff, pull it off with air.
Hmm. fuzzy fucking mess is what you want. Pull that light away. So you're splaying the ends?
I'm just trying to get it packed real good on the ends so that it's not, because we pulled on it, it's going to get real flared out on the end, so we're trying to get it all kind of packed a little bit. Gotcha. Plus, we can't quite cut it where we want to cut it perfectly, so we kind of got to settle. See, in a real world, if we could find one that was bent like that, it would be better, but in a perfect world, we don't get nothing perfect. This and take screwdrivers and pack it. Then we'll work on the cap real good and try to get it
form fitted.
Yeah, something at least resembling the shape that it might.
Nice and rusted up, so
it gives an extra grip.
Yeah, clearancing. This is one of those YouTube videos that would prove why guys don't use rope seals, because they're way too.
You know, it's very difficult.
They're too involved to put in.
Yeah. And it's all about this right here, this little, those two little mating surfaces, getting them right, because if you don't, it just won't seal. It leaks right at the parting line, just like a neoprene seal does, and you can't put freaking silicone on like you do a neoprene, so.
Surface is way fucking worse than I thought it was.
It's pretty bad. The pictures you did, I enlarged them, and you can see there's some pretty tough places. And all it has to have is one little section. Even the crank's got a couple little divots in it, but the bearings look all right. Don't worry about it.
It makes a shitload of oil pressure, so.
Yeah, that's good.
You want to, we can slowly put some tension on the caps and rotate it.
Yeah, we don't want to rotate it now.
Thank you. pen.
Where's your Hulk oil again?
We got the sax man right here on KOCC up on Sunday morning. We're going to let out a rather yell with Billy Idol after a short time.
405.7 KOCC. Yeah, when I was going through this, I was getting torch traps off of the internet and I confused. They got 426 stuff kind of intermingled with wedge stuff. So I was tightening the rod bolts way too tight and I twisted one of the bolts off. And that's a feeling that just is indescribable. It took me the better part of an hour or so to weld a nut on it and then get the fucker out of there. But it was a learning experience. It was actually kind of fun. So I go down to Hughes. And I'm begging those guys for rod bolts. They're like, fuck, we got a coffee can full of that shit. Just pick what you want. I'm like, I don't know what I'm fucking looking for. So I donated a set of rod bolts.
Those blue ones aren't too bad for getting in. I tried those. There's a hollow tooth looking one made out of viton. They're just ridiculous. There's no structure to them, so yeah, I might look not use this one. Corners right down there. I saw a vapor trail there.
Let me wipe that one more time. pretty tight. Maybe take it around.
Yeah, I think we're good.